So next discuss our topic emergency of towns and ports. Emergency of towns and ports. The Sangam age saw the first urbanization in Tamilagam. Cities developed and they had brick buildings, roof tiles, ring wells and planned towns, sheds and storehouses. The towns worked as ports and artisanal centers. Arikkamedu, Kaveri Pubattinam, Alaganakulam and Korkai on the east coast and Pattanam in Kerala were port centers. Kanjipuram, Urayur, Karur, Madurai and Kodumanal were inland trade centers. Many goods and commodities were produced in these centers and were exported to various regions. The few in number large towns appeared in the Sangam age. Small villages, however, were found in many areas. Bronze vessel, beads, shell bangles, glass beads, pottery with name of the people written in Tamil Brahmi script were found at these cities. So next discuss the topic faith and belief system. Faith and belief system, that's animism. Animism, that means what, children? That means what? The bad evils. That's the bad evils. Like device the nature of society and economy, the belief system of Sangam age was also diverse. It consists of animism, ancestor worship, hero worship and the worship of the several deities. You know that animism, it is what, children? It is the bad evils. Another one, ancestor worship. Ancestor worship, Amsuna, that means your grandfather, it is one died. That is one ancestor worship. Another one, hero worship. Hero worship during the war time. Who that person victory in that war, that person so worship to a hero worship. Another one, worship to for several deities. Tolkapiyam list the presiding deities of Kurinji, Mullai, Marudam, Neidal and Palai landscape as Murugan, Tirumal, Indiran, Varunan and Kottavai respectively. However, people also worshipped natural forces and dead heroes and ancestors. The force of Anugu is mentioned in the literature indicates the prevalence of the animistic beliefs. Jainism was present as evidenced by the curse with Tamil Brahmi inscription. The performance of yoga, yagna is also evidenced. The Buddhism was also present in certain center. Different groups practiced various form of worship. So next, culture of arts. So next, discuss the topic culture of arts. Various culture forms too existed in the Sangam age. Performance of ritual dance called performance of the ritual dance is called the veri odal or referred to in the literature. Composition of poems, playing of the music instrument and dances were also known. The literature mentioned in the fine variety of cuisine of the Sangam age. Cuisine, that means what, children? The cuisine, that means what? Now it is on the, there's a food, it's kinds of the cooking food. Sangam age, people took care of their appearance and evidence of antimony roads. The made of copper has been found in archaeological site. They were used to women for decorating their eyebrows. So let us recall the point. So history lesson 3, early Tamil society and the culture. So beginning you have learning the Tolkapiyam, Aingurunooru, epic poems. Another one, Tamil society, in particularly it is a development of an next one there, Sangam age, Sangam society. Another one, Sangam economy. That is another one, during the emergency of the towns and ports, it is to create a watch and it is on the urbanization. Thank you. Good morning, children. Have a nice day. Standard 9th History Unit 3. Early Tamil Society and Culture. Already discussed the topic, five types of the lands, Sangam Polity, Sangam Economy and Learning. So now Sangam Economy la nam learn panna learning part means of transport. It is the means of transport. What is the means of the transport? The bullock carts and animals were used to transport goods by land. Trade routes linked the various towns of Tamilagam. Various types of water and crops and sea growing vessels such as column, pegri, odam, toni, teppam and novel. This is all the types of the water, crops and the sea going vessels mentioned in the Tamil literature. So next, batter and the coin. What's the meaning of the batter? The exchange of goods for goods. That's the meaning batter. So batter is a primary mode of exchange. It's a primary mode of exchange. For instance, the rice was exchanged for fish. What children? The rice was exchanged for fish. The salt was precious and a handful of it would fetch an equal amount of rice. The extensive availability of the coin hoards of Tamilagam, the hoards of the Sangam age of the Cheras, Cholas, Pandyas, Malayaman, they indicate they were used, it is one widely. So next we'll discuss the topic, Tamilagam and overseas interaction. Tamilagam and overseas interaction. Tamil society had a connection with the countries overseas both in east and west. Roman ships, they used the monsoon winds to cross the Western Sea or the Arabian Sea to connect the Tamilagam with the Western world. Spices including pepper, ivory and precious stones were exported. Metal including gold, silver and copper and precious stones were imported. So next, Tamil Nadu to Red Sea coast. It's a very important one. An Indian jar with 7.5 kg of pepper take wood, a portrait with Tamil Brahmi inscription and Indian pottery have been discovered at Bernik, the port of Red Sea in the coast of Egypt. And the next, at Qasri al-Qadim. At Qasri al-Qadim, this is what, that is from the another port. The located north of Bernik on the Red Coast, the three Tamilagam Brahmi inscription, Tamil Brahmi inscription have been found on the pottery discovered here. A stone with the name the Perum Potankal have been found at Hun Lukpat, Thailand. Southeast Asia was known as Swarna Bhumi in Tamil literature. Southeast Asia was known as Swarna Bhumi in Tamil literature. This stone was used by a person is called the Perum Potan, probably a goldsmith. It was the touchstone used to test the purity of gold.